What's up, guys? Coach Grant with First Down Training, and today we're going to be breaking down three tips for slot wide receivers to improve their skills and take their game to that next level. So we're going to be talking about how you guys can attack an outside leverage DB when you have an outside breaking route, how you guys can beat a physical linebacker who lines up inside shade of you when you have to run a vertical route like a dig or a post, and then how you guys can close the distance in man coverage with a safety walk down on you. So I hope this video helps you guys out. But also, fellas, we just got back from our Atlanta, Georgia quarterback and wide receiver training camp. We really want to thank everybody who came out and participated, but now we're going to be traveling out to five more states for our off-season camp tour. We're coming out to Columbus, Ohio, Chicago, Illinois, Dallas, Texas, Nashville, Tennessee, and Los Angeles, California. So we've already been to about five states across the country, and we're really excited to get out to these next five. So if you guys would like to come out for a two-day long training camp, 4 hours each day, 8 hours of work, wide receiver specific drills, one-on-one standoff to camp, check out that very first link in the description below. We'd absolutely love to have you out to one of our camps. Let's get started with this video. So now, first things first, as a slot wide receiver, I'm going to play this clip full speed. We have to run a lot of routes, a lot of outside breaking routes like outs, corners, versus this outside shade coverage off man. So why do we see that as a slot receiver? So let's play this route full speed. So this wide receiver does a great job of attacking the inside shoulder, breaking it off, and then being able to accelerate out. So why do I see that, right? So this wide receiver's cut down, obviously, very close to the hash mark. So this could be like a slot wide receiver position and maybe like a doubles formation. So if you get man coverage, right? What do slot wide receivers like to run a lot of? They like to run a lot of outside breaking routes. They like to run a lot of 10-yard outs, 5-yard outs, corners, because they're trying to use all this space that they have towards the sideline. So you're going to be seeing a lot of outside shade off man coverage. So the mistake that a lot of guys will make is that they try to force this outside release. They try to force the corner, force the out route, force the 5-yard out with an outside release. They try to just simply run around this defender. But we have to understand why he's playing me that specific way. So he's lined up outside shade. So what does that mean? He's lined up outside shade because he's expecting the outside route. He thinks that, okay, he's a slot wide receiver. He's probably going to be running an outside route. But then you might ask yourself, oh, well, wouldn't that open up the inside part of the field? Wouldn't that allow me to just be able to run a post, a dig, or like maybe just a quick slant and cross his face and run if it's man coverage? He's only going to be playing you outside shade if he has safety help. So he's completely fine with you doing that and just taking off because maybe it's like a cover one robber. Maybe there's a safety look. Maybe it's two man, whatever it is, but he has help to the inside and he's expecting an outside route. Slot wide receivers love to see this. So how do you attack this coverage? So if I have a route like a 10 yard out, a lot of guys, like I said, will force the release. They try to just run around this DB, but all this DB is going to do, because his sole responsibility is not to give up the outside, is if you force the release, he's going to weave with you. You're going to break this off and he's going to be right on your hip because you never sold vertical. The main thing about your stem, about your release, is you have to keep timing with the quarterback and you have to give your quarterback space to throw you open on this case. So what we would do is we would want to attack the inside shoulder of the DB. We would want to try to get him to flip his hips so I could slip back underneath and have space for my quarterback to throw me open. So that's exactly what he does. He comes off here. He's got great speed into the route. He's in full stride. Hips and shoulders are pointed vertical, pumping those arms, attacking the inside shoulder. That is what will get the DB to flip his hips. Because at the end of the day, it's still man coverage. And at the end of the day, we still could get separation on an inside route. So we got to make him believe that. We have to make him flip his hips, commit to the fade, and then I am very sudden with my break point. So slot wide receivers, understand that it is about using your stem and attacking the inside shoulder of a DB when you have an outside break route against outside leverage coverage, okay? Because that is a common coverage that you will see, common look from a DB that you will see if you're lined up in the slot, because they love to expect those outside routes from us. So let's play this thing again full speed one more time. This is textbook right here on how to run an outside breaking route versus outside leverage off man coverage. Play it again full speed. Great job attacking inside shoulder, getting him to flip his hips, and then breaking this thing right off on this route. So now, second thing we want to talk about, and this is a common look that you see as a slot. This is a clip here from Odell. So you're going to see a linebacker, maybe a nickel type defender, and maybe you're getting double teamed, right? It could be a double team situation, but sometimes what you'll have is you'll have a linebacker, whether it's maybe a 4-4 front, you know, a 4-3, regardless, it could be something different, could be a 3-4, whatever. That doesn't necessarily matter. But what matters is that you have, for this specific situation, but what matters is you have a second level, or like a first level defender who's lined up maybe inside shade or head up on you. And then you have a safety lined up over the top of him. And if you have to run a route like a dig or a post, a lot of times this guy's sole responsibility is to get hands on you and to reroute you and screw up the spacing of the play. So many wide receivers struggle with this because they just try to run around this guy. They'll come off the line and they just try to go around him with speed. That is exactly what he wants you to do because he's going to get hands, screw you off into the outside wide receiver where a corner could maybe cover the outside guy and the slot wide receiver. So your spacing is important. Spacing on your routes are so important out of the slot because you're either going to get the ball or you're drawing another defender to crash down on you so another wide receiver will be open. That's the end of the day. That's what route running is about. So we cannot be afraid of this guy, and I cannot try to run around this guy. So let's play this thing full speed for Modell. He does a great job attacking this DB, getting him to sit inside, push him back up vertical, getting that safety to bail off, as you can see, and being able to create some kind of separation. That is textbook as to what you want to do, because we want to attack the guy that's in front of me. I want to be able to sell vertical to get the safety out of there, and that will give me this window. Whether I am being double teamed like this out of the slot, or whether it is just a true maybe cover four concept where you got a outside backer, a nickel DB, whatever it is, playing in front of you, inside shade or head up, and then you have a safety shaded over the top. That is what we have to do. So again, what does he do up the line? He's running this stop route. He does not just try to run around and go run the stop route. He attacks him. Let's attack this DB's leverage. Let's give him a move to the inside so that creates space for me to push back outside. Now, after he pushes around this DB, what is he doing? He's pushing vertical. He's got great speed. His hips and his shoulders are committed vertical. He's not slowing down. He's not slowly starting to turn and give away his break to make it easy on the safety. He attacks this guy, gets him to move. Let's push back up vertical. Let's get into my route. If he had to run a corner route, he could run a corner route. If he had to run a dig route, he could run a dig. If he's got to stop it off like he does right now, he could easily do that. But your stem gets this safety out of there. Because when that safety, when it's like maybe a too high look out of the slot, it's almost like off-man coverage like we just talked about. And an off-man, that guy's watching your hips. That guy's trying to read your body language. Your speed is going to get him out of there and selling vertical. So that's how we have to think. So I get this linebacker off, the nickel off, push back vertical, get the safety to bail, and that is what creates enough separation for me to make a play. That is textbook right there, what you need to do out of the slot when you have that linebacker look who's inside shade or head up. Do not be afraid of that defender. Attack the defender. Give him something quick because we do not want to waste time as well, and then get up into the route. Like I said, give him something quick because a lot of wide receivers will do this and then they hesitate. They do all this fancy footwork and that screws up timing. Your release needs to keep timing, but it also needs to give you space and allow you to sell vertical and get separation on your route. Let's watch the thing again, full speed one more time. Great job by Odell setting up that DB inside, pushing back vertical, and then snapping this route right off to create some separation. So now, out of the slot, right? We're looking at Devontae Adams. Sometimes you were going to be seeing this type of coverage in man where you got like a 2 to 3 yard cushion. They call it catch technique from a DB. So why would a DB ever play catch technique and why do we see this out of the slot? So pretty much this will be against like more shiftier guys. Like out of the slot, you're probably on the shiftier side, maybe smaller, quicker side of things. You will see this type of coverage because what the DB wants you to do is like if you're running a vertical route like a fade or maybe you have to get up to 12 yards to run a dig or maybe a corner, he wants you to just try to run around him so he could get hands and essentially catch you, quote unquote, catch you and get hands and reroute and just screw up the timing with the quarterback. So as a wide receiver, it's very similar to the last clip that we just talked about when you have that linebacker who's in zone, shifted inside shade, and his goal is to reroute you outside. You cannot be afraid of this guy, and you have to close the cushion with this guy. Anytime that this DB is in catch or he's maybe inching back just a tad, getting into his motor, you have to close space with him. So let's watch this thing full speed. Adams does a great job closing space, giving that crossover move, and then being able to create some separation on that slant. I'll play it again full speed one more time. He does not run away from this guy. He is getting close to this guy and threatening his cushion to make him uncomfortable. Whether you're maybe, even if he's like right up on the line of scrimmage and he starts to bail initially, or he's in this catch technique, we have to make him uncomfortable. I have to close the distance. I have to try to put him on his heels. Because if I put him on his heels and I get him to start inching back, he is very uncomfortable right here. He could easily get beat on a fade. We could easily take him up vertical and just try to run around him. But when we close the distance and I could give him this crossover move, step outside of his frame, get him to hesitate to the outside, that gives me plenty of space to the inside and make this cut. So that's a perfect example. That's the last thing that slot wide receivers need to focus on is when you get this man coverage catch technique, make sure we are closing the distance. Almost think of it like stepping on the toes of the DB to make him uncomfortable so we can create space. Let's play this thing again, full speed one more time. Great job by Adams closing the the distance, throwing the crossover, and then creating plenty of separation over the middle to win against man coverage out of the slot. All right, fellas, I really want to thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. If you guys have any questions at all, don't hesitate to leave those in the comment section below. We'll get back to you as soon as we can. We always appreciate the feedback, and we read every comment, so it helps keep the channel going. We really appreciate it. And again, fellas, we're coming out to 5 different states this offseason. We're coming out to Columbus. Then we're going to be coming out to Chicago, Illinois, Dallas, Texas, Nashville, Tennessee, and Los Angeles, California. 2-day-long quarterback and wide receiver training camps, 4 hours each day, small group atmosphere. So check out that very first link in the description below. We'd love to have you out to one of our camps. See you guys next time.